Muscles in the thoracic wall are subcostalis. Three intercostal muscles and transversus thoracis. They change the thoracic cavity's volume during respiration. Now let's subject these muscles to examination. The subcostalis muscle helps support the thoracic cage. Pulls ribs down during forced exhalation, it's engaged. All three intercostal muscles aid forced breathing and in short. They're accessory respiration muscles giving ribcage support. While external intercostals help with forced inspiration. The internal and innermost ones aid forced expiration. Nearest the skin, external intercostal muscles obscure. Internal intercostals, the middle intercostal musculature. The innermost intercostals are the deepest muscle layer. Pulling ribs down on exhalation, they're a key player. Note that this muscle is continuous with the diaphragm, which separates two cavities. See this diagram. The diaphragm is the primary muscle of respiration. It contracts to expand the lungs for inspiration. The transversus thoracis muscle aids forced expiration. And that is basically this muscle's only action. Some muscles don't comprise but attach to the thoracic wall. The pec serratus anterior and the scalenes, y'all. The pec major and minor are on the anterior chest wall. With sternal and clavicular heads, pec major superficial. And it serves to adduct your arm or bring it towards your core. And rotates your arm medially as its second chore. The minor forms part of the axilla's anterior wall. And it pulls the scapula to the thoracic wall. Serratus anterior holds the scapula to the rib cage. It rotates the scapula, which gives your arm more range. Anterior, middle, posterior, scalene muscles on each side. A floor for the next posterior triangle help provide. The scalene muscles raise the ribs during forced inspiration and cause neck flexion, lateral flexion, and rotation.
If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out all of our other anatomy songs.